Alkali-silica reaction is probably one of the most detrimental forms of degradation of concrete. It's a very slow and an insidious process that occurs over a long period of time, and it compromises the structural integrity or the mechanical integrity of concrete structures over time.
You cannot conveniently replace a nuclear power plant, and many of the nuclear power plants that found to have this problem is right now up for renewal license.
We are providing the tools to the U.S. Nuclear Regulatory Commission to evaluate their structures that are exposed or affected by distress due to ASR. We divided the project into 5 tasks, 3 structurally based and 2 materials based.
We're looking on the material side at damage. They're looking at basically the effects of damage. The project required that we design 3 concrete mixes, each with different levels of severity or reactivity.
We designed and constructed 3 blocks with those reactive aggregates, in addition to a control block that was done with sound concrete, no ASR.
In addition to those specimens, we have a whole host, a whole series of smaller companion specimens that we have cast from those same mixes of concrete, so that we can make independent measurements on a smaller scale, but in more detail.
Because of the short duration of the project, we had to accelerate that reaction. So by keeping the specimens, whether they are the blocks or beams or shear walls, in the environmental chamber exposed to high humidity and elevated temperatures, that would allow them to reach the same expansion that they would have reached have they been in service in a real structure, but over so many years. We constructed these shear walls with the same reactive mix as the beams, and we test them under vertical load, representative of gravity loading on the walls, and also under lateral load, typical of what you would experience under seismic loading.
Ultimately, for this project, what we need to do is relate expansion and the damage characteristics and quantification that we're doing on the smaller specimens. We need to be able to relate that to what's going on in the larger specimens.
For the beams, for example, despite the fact that you get some reduction in the mechanical properties of the concrete material, the structure as a whole performed as intended. We didn't see a reduction in the overall capacity of these beams.
Historically, research into ASR sort of been done with a kind of a black box mentality. They either look at the aggregate or the concrete, or they look at the structures, but very seldom do they integrate the two. And I think that's what's unique about this study, is that we are actually trying to do just that.